Professor Ashutosh Sharma, all of you, very good evening. Anyway, Dr. Saraswat, being my earlier boss and now also, then he was there in DRDO, I covered already some part of the defense related thing. But let me start saying that if you look at the three major departments, whatever strategic departments, particularly atomic energy, ISRO, and DRDO, the change start producing, the scenario has changed about 35 to 40 years back onwards. That's where things started moving, experiments, large experiments, and many of the systems being developed and all that. With particularly the three leaders in the three departments coming, Dr. Homi J. Baba, Dr. Vikram Sarabhai, and then in defense, particularly in the missiles area, Dr. APJ Abdul Kalam, leading all the developmental activities. Primarily what I feel is, particularly in the defense sector, when you look at it, when we didn't have almost anything, we were almost importing everything, the concentration of the leadership was to produce some things of our own somehow here. So you were more concentrating on engineering, you were more concentrating on development and making a product how you need to develop it and produce it to the users. That's how the work more started and started yielding the results in some of the products development. So that's how today in defense, if you look at it, you have developed all those things what we are saying, whether it is the missiles, Prithvi to Agni to whatever varieties of missiles, whatever you are talking, or Arjun tank, or the aircrafts, fighter aircrafts, or the torpedoes, or the radars, and whatnot, and many of the things. Particularly in some of the areas, because you stabilized, you started getting into some of the R&D, into the core areas also. So you could develop some of the materials and things like that, what are required for the missiles and things like that. And that's how you could achieve today. You are in a very comfortable stage where you could launch within 1 week a 5,000 kilometers missile, and then yesterday a 4,000 kilometers missile also, showing the strength of yours in those areas. Similarly, if you look at the Department of Space, started from SLV where Dr. Kalam was there, the project director, then you went to ASLV, then you are PSLV, and today PSLV is a vehicle which I think last mission was the 36th consecutive successful flight test of the PSLV. 36 in a row they had a successful mission, and then you had a GSLV, you have Mars mission, you have Moon mission, and also trying for re-entry experiment has been done, and then you're working on a space station and many of those things. But then with all these developments what have been done in the 30-40 years, still look at my department, defense, we are still the probably now we're the second largest importer of arms and equipment in the world today, the defense equipment. Second largest, we are to feel bad about it. In fact, last aero show when the honorable prime minister was addressing, he was saying that I don't want to stand as a prime minister of a country which is the, that time was the largest importer of arms and equipment, and so I don't want to stand as that, and so we need to reduce the imports and start improving further and then try to export. So what you need to do, there are two things. One is, what are your current needs, what you are still importing, various parts, whatnot and everything, maintenance related, some of the equipment what you need, some of the current developments what are going on, so what are the equipment what you need and things like that. This is one aspect, which actually reduces your import. This is one important need what we have. So this is where the department has taken many steps involving academia, involving industry, how they can participate in defense in a big way. So like, first thing is, we made open all those products what needs to be indigenously developed here, and you need to produce, whether you call it indigenously developed or indigenization. So you need to make, so a list of all those products have been made, and they have been made public, saying that these are what we require and these are what quantities are also required, so that they are economically viable. So this is number one. Once this is made, and there are many people who come forward saying that I will develop this and then I need to have the facilities and things like that, I need to work with you. So the facilities which are there with the MOD, Ministry of Defense, they have been made again open to those people who are able to develop, who are able to work, who have the potential to develop these things. They have been made public in the sense they can come, they can test, they can evaluate, they can integrate with the systems and things like that is the second part. Third, a technology development fund has been created. Somebody has got a good design, he is able to come out, and but he needs some infrastructure. We can give the technology development fund to those people, industry, individuals, whoever it is, or even academia. You can fund them so that you will be able to come out with a product which can be innovative product or just one-to-one replacement of an existing product which you are importing today. Fourth, supporting the innovation. Today's world, when you look at it, the youngsters, the way they are coming out with the ideas is really fantastic ideas. Many people are coming. In fact, even today evening, some people are meeting me today who have come out with some of the excellent ideas, both for defense and space related also, from some connected to UAVs, some connected to other radar applications and things like that, some connected to RCS reduction, to plasma and all those things. And many people have come. And the way they are there, but they have ideas and you need to support them. A supportive mechanism need to be created. So such a mechanism has been created, which is called Innovation Research Initiative from the MOD. Again, you evaluate the idea, you can support them both using the facilities, you can provide your own facilities to them, or you can fund them and things like that. This one more what MOD has taken, I think Department of Defense Production has taken this idea. And so, as a whole, if you look at it, MOD has created many mechanisms how you can cope up with the people who are coming out with many ideas, many designs and things like that. So this is what one area. Now second, if you want to go further, you need to, any industry which is coming up here, he will not be able to survive with the domestic market alone. The market will not be sufficient for him to sustain for a long period. Needs to come out a product which can he can sell all over the world. So if you want to have a product which you can sell all over the world, then you need to be having a product which is the state of art product. If you want to have a state of the art product, then it doesn't come just with an engineering. You may be able to innovate a product or engineer a product, but you need to do right from the beginning a basic research onwards. Actually, when you look at the one concept what I want to say here is, as I said, we concentrated in the last 30-40 years more on engineering, development and things like that. The roles of the three major constituents, academia, R&D institutes and then industry. The roles have been like this. Industry, which was more like was very minimal in 30-40 years back, they have remained more as suppliers. They have been more as suppliers till recent times where they started getting into some amount of development and things like that. R&D institutes, we've been more concentrating on development and engineering, majorly. The academic institutes have been more concentrating on translational research and some maybe applied research. Very few concentrating on the basic research. So if you want to have a state-of-the-art product to come after 7 years or 10 years or 12 years today, the roles need to be redefined. The academic institutes need to concentrate at least 30-40% on basic research. And then remaining, of course, on the applied research and translational research. Then the R&D institutes, what we are, we need to have translational research, applied research, and of course, development. Maybe 30% of applied to translational research, 40% 32 translational applied to translational research, and then 40% development and remaining 20% upgradation of products and things like that. Coming to the industry, they definitely need to do at least about 15% of their research in the niche areas. There are many industries in India who have come out with many products concentrating on niche areas. Like, let's say, today about satellite communication, satellite navigation systems. India is one of the leading countries in the world making such products out of the complete research done in a private industry. So likewise, like the way what we have exceedingly done well in ICT area, information communication technology area, where we have come out with many innovative products, innovative ideas, the industry needs to come out with some amount of R&D in the niche areas, about 15-20%, remaining being a production or whatever it is, numbers you have to produce, quantity you have to produce with the quality and things like that. So unless this type of a system comes out where you have redefined your roles, we will remain in the same type of phenomenon even after 10 to 12 years. So if we need to make a product where the services or the users or the armed forces are readily looking for this product, or we can sell it across, we need to develop a product which is contemporary. Why I'm using this word is, we generally have been technology followers. This word is, we generally have been technology followers. So this technology follower, the moment what a technology comes, a product comes, when you make an equivalent product after about 8 years or 10 years, then nobody has got any interest in that, including our own people. So you need to be contemporary, meaning a technology has come, a product has come, within about 2 to 3 years, you are also able to come out with a product. Then you have a lot of market within the country, and also you have market outside. So to do this, we need to identify the areas what we need to work on. See, definitely Dr. Saraswat has given a lot of list of some of those technologies what are there. Similarly, in the defense, when I say that, in the defense areas, what are the areas what we need to work now to become one of the leading nations in that technology, we need to identify the departments in the particular universities or academic institutes who have good professors or good department who can do a good amount of research in that area, who can help, who can come out with a good basic research and support you, and so that you can get a product. This is a very important thing. If universities, if we don't get good professors or good departments who can do an in-depth research, not a superficial or translational or a developmental research, it is very difficult to find a product which can be a state-of-the-art product which is going to come. This is a very important thing what we need to do. I wish that universities are going to come up to that level, and we change ourselves from development engineering to applied research laboratories, and industry comes up, then I think India can become really a leading country in the next 5 to 10 years in all these technologies. Thank you very much for giving me.